Look, I'm going to stick up for him, I think, but I don't know, maybe I'm too soft-bound, but you tell me. Anthony Albanese now, the Prime Minister, is being attacked by his own tenant for wanting now to evict him from the home that is rented out to this bloke for, what is it, 4 years or something. Here's the tenant.
It's so disruptive when you get an eviction notice. I know all landowners are entitled to do that. It just wreaks absolute havoc at the moment. You know, we're dealing with cost of living crisis, probably the worst rental crisis certainly ever I can remember in Sydney. We've got a massive shortage of properties and options are pretty limited. Look, as a Labor voter, I'm a little confused as well. It just doesn't seem aligned with the information that's come out in budget week. Clearly there's an emphasis from the Labor government on wanting to do what they can to protect and support renters and understand the cost of living crisis that we're all going through. This doesn't seem fully in line with that.
Now, Albanese says it's actually been charging this bloke half the usual rent since the pandemic, and is thinking to sell the property, which is, I think is absolutely is right, you know. But the Greens today attacked. Here they are.
If we take a landlord, let's call him Anthony, he can increase the rent by however much he wants and evict his tenant so he can sell the property for a big profit. When selling the property, he can get to keep 50% of a $500,000 profit he makes completely tax-free thanks to Labor's handouts to property investors, which deny renters the ability to buy their first home. Does the Prime Minister think that's more than fair?
Barnaby Joyce, where do you stand here? Is the problem that Albanese is a bastard landlord and greedy, or is the tenant who's trying to, you know, publicly shame him to stay there just paying the price for being so stupid as to vote for a Labor government that's caused so much immigration he can't find a new home at the same price?
Well, if you want to change cost of living crisis, get rid of this cultish attachment to swindle factories, the so-called renewables. Stop giving billions and billions of dollars to carpetbaggers at home and multinational companies overseas, filling the ceiling with Moet corks as the champagne bottles are popping in the climate change fraternity. But look. If someone buys a rental house, if you move into a rental house, it is a rental house. And a rental house comes with certain conditions. And one of the conditions is the person who owns it may, at a time of their choosing, decide to cease the rent. And that's just how commerce works. And it works for Mr. Albanese like it works for everybody else. So, you know, if you don't want to live in a rental house, then, you know, you have to find a house to buy. And if you can't afford one in Sydney, then you have to start looking at regional cities and regional towns where maybe you could afford to buy. I mean, I understand, I have empathy, but I don't know how much sympathy I have for a person who says, I want to live in the middle of Sydney and I want to live in a rental house and I want to make sure that the person who owns the house can never kick me out. You know, I live out in the country and I bought my first house in Werris Creek, you know, and I bought it for, what was it, $70,000 or $69,000. Whereas Creek, I think I...